Alright, so this is Shop Titans, I'm Last Obelisk, and this is a tutorial to how to upgrade your heroes to about 20,000 power. It's probably one of the major upgrades you're going to want to do in order to get yourself moving forward into the end game. So I don't need anybody that I need to upgrade right now, nor do I have the funds, so I'm just going to pick somebody and show you how to do it. So like, we'll use my Geomancer for example. Okay, the first thing you want to do is assess the potential of the hero. So you go to your skills, and then you need to look at all of the skills that you have available. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add up all of the percentage attack that we can get on this hero. If you have somebody like a knight or a tank or something, you can use defense. Not everything scales the same. Attack is really gonna get you to where you wanna be in order to kill things faster, but defense is also another good stat. So for this guy, we're gonna do percentage attack. His passive skill, as you can see right here, it's 40% attack plus 1% attack per point in any element. This is maxed out, but some of yours might not be maxed out yet. So what you want to do is click on the eye at the bottom, and then you can see the different levels of it. When you put 90 of 90 water element into it, it maxes out his passive. So that's how I got to that. Otherwise, it's going to read something lower. But you need to find whatever the highest is in each of the skills to know the maximum potential of that skill, because in the end, you're going to have the 90 of 90 water that you need. So for him, this first passive skill, 40% attack, 1% attack per point in any element. Then you're going to want to check the rest of your skills. So I move on to the next one, click on the eye. I see that the highest tier of this is plus 50% attack. I'm not really concentrated on the defense, but you know, it's good to have it there if it's there, whatever. Some skills are going to have lower attack than others. Obviously, you want the ones that are going to give you the most. So that skill's got 50% attack. And then we move on to the next one. Click on the eye again. Maxed out here is 100% attack. And then check the other one that's available to me because I'm not level 35 yet. This one is plus 80% attack. Okay, now if you have something that doesn't add attack or something that's on the low side of attack or you just want more out of it, you have the option to reroll the skill. You can either use a dice to do this or a die and or gems. So depending on what you have is what you want to use. They go up in price exponentially if you want to use gems, so I would suggest using gems on like maybe the first two skills and save your dice for the higher skills because they'll cost you more gems if you don't. And we'll just show you something real quick. So clicking on that first skill, I go to reroll. These are a list of all the skills that are available that could potentially replace the skill that's on there. You can click any of these arrows and you can see that, you know, a bunch of different skills or whatever. Some of them aren't that great. Then there's these ones right here that are plus damage to a certain weapon type. These are great because they will ultimately get up to 150% with that type of weapon. They don't stack though, because you can only hold one weapon at a time. So, you know, if you got a mace, then, you know, stick with the mace. Don't have two of these because that will just be a waste of a spot and then you won't get any attack damage for that certain weapon type. That's just common. You know, there's like the other different kinds. Some are better than others. You need to just figure out what you want. Try to roll for it. If you get something good, you know, stop there. Don't get crazy, because if you do, then, you know, you're going to spend a lot and it's really not worth it. So once you figure that out, you figure out how much percentage of attack that each character has, then that's where you want to start working. So I didn't add it all up this time because I already did all that. But it's like over 300 and something attack, 300% attack. Okay, once you have that down, you go back to your character, and then you're just gonna want to unequip everything. You don't even need to see it anymore. It doesn't need to be there because you're gonna get whatever is best for your character. So you want to start with your weapon. Click on your weapon slot, and then you're gonna want to equip from the market. It's gonna open the market up, and it's gonna give you some of the highest stuff that you can find. What you're looking for is the highest tier legendary that you can get that will give you the highest attack possible. That's what this little sword is here. That's how much attack is on that weapon. The higher the attack, the better. So my Geomancer didn't have any specific weapon type, so I'm free to just pick whatever I want. You have to keep in mind what you're spending, because sometimes it's just not worth it. Like if you look right here, this Equinox Rod is 640 gems and it's a 1560 attack. If you just go down a little bit from that, you know, you have this Wand of Midas here that is 248 gems with 1230 attack. Now you could spend what you want, that's fine. The higher this number is though, ultimately is gonna lead to you being stronger. This is like the most important part of all of this. So if you want to splurge and get the best thing possible, get the highest attack you can, and then go from there. It's important that it's legendary because that's going to get you the highest you can get. So then you would want to buy something. Some of these items are for gold. So if you want to spend gold, you could like buy this for 12,700,000 if you really want to take that route and you don't want to spend gems or you don't have them. But it's significantly lower though. That's like 1,170 versus the highest thing that's on here. That's 1,560. That's quite a bit of attack, especially because all of the skills you just looked at are based off percentages. So whatever your base attack is going to be amplified by that percentage. So the lower the number, the lower you're going to get. So you want something that's really high here. So I'm not going to buy anything because I already have weapons for this guy, like I said. So I'm just going to go back and equip mine because I have it in my inventory here. Put that back on him. So once you do that, you can just, you know, leave it be for the moment, and then you want to equip the rest of your gear. So move on to the next thing. Equip from market again. In this case, you could do whatever you wanted, whatever tier, but we're trying to save money here. So you're either going to want to stick with something that is common or uncommon, because you're going to start getting into spending gems if you don't. But also, you also want something with attack. So here in this scenario, the only thing with the attack is the Austera vest, and it gives you 48 and 190 defense. So I would buy this because that's going to add to the weapon, which is going to add to the percentage, which is going to give your total and make your total even higher. So just looking at this stuff, like, it would either be this plain one or this uncommon one or common or whatever they're called. And I'd want to stick there. Also, you have to keep in mind that when this stuff breaks in battle, you're gonna have to repair it. So like, that's gonna cost you a lot more too. So if you're not like real far into end game, you wanna stay on the lower side of things. So I would probably buy this Austera vest is what I would get. And then I would get that and I would equip it. And that's what I have. See, I actually have that for myself, except I have the green one because I wanted a little bit more attack there. And you just keep on going through, equip from market, see what's available. Remember, you're gonna wanna get, you know, greens and plain ones. In this case, the Raven Mask looks the best. The plain one has 48 attack. The green one has 60. I think here I got the green one as well, so I'll just equip that from my inventory. These items aren't going to have the enchantments in them yet, so we'll get to that in a minute, though. I'll just keep going on. You need to do every item like that. So, okay, here's a perfect case where there is no attack. There's a solution to this to get you more attack. You can either choose to do it this way, or you can take one of these items, but remember, your overall attack is going to be lower if you don't do what I'm about to show you. So you click on this, and these are the different tiers right here of items. So check the next tier down, tier 8, there's no attack. So we'll try tier 7, still no attack. I think in this case it's tier 5, you just move down so you find it, and there it is. So there's some Austera gloves. Still want to stick with the plain ones. It's not a lot of attack, but every little bit is going to help in your overall power because it's a percentage. So in this case, I'd buy the green one again because, you know, that's still kind of cheap for me there. So we'll go back and see what I have. I think I have that and I'll equip it. And I do. And then you're going to keep moving on. Equip from market. See what your green is, see what your plain is. So here we go. Here's a green. This is the one that I have, actually. It's 838 for a million gold there. The plain ones become a little bit cheaper, but also the attack goes down. So I'm just going to go back and equip what I have here just to speed this up a little bit. Same thing, you'd want to equip from market, do the same thing. This was the item that I had. So once you have all that done, you need to go back to your skills and see how much you're going to need to max out these skills. What you do is you need to check all of them. So right here it tells you you're going to need 90 of 90 water element to get this maxed out here. You need to check them individually. This one is 35. That number right there is your highest one. This one is 35 also, and this one is 65. So you just need the highest one. You don't need to add them all up. This will be its passive here, which is at 90. So we know we need 90. In order to get 90, you have to have a plus 15 water in every one of these slots. If you don't need 90, you can get away with maybe skipping putting one on your weapon, because everything for your weapon now is going to cost more because it's a legendary. So you want to click on the weapon, click on the slot there. I can't replace it because, you know, that's not good for me right now. But it will give you the option, if you don't already own it, to equip it from the market. You go there like you did your armor and stuff, and then you just buy the enchantment. So you do that, and you get as many as you need. You just have to figure out the math, so they're all maxed out. Obviously, do your weapon last. And then you want to do your spirit. In this case, we're going to use the wolf spirit on everything, because it adds 5% attack to your total percentage of attack that you got from your skills. So if you put a wolf spirit in all six of your slots here, it's going to give you an additional plus 30% attack. So you're going to want to do that for all of them, unless you have a different character that you're going like defense or something, then you want to switch them. There are some higher tier ones that add attack and give you something else as well, but we're trying to keep it as cheap as possible. These wolf spirits are like 16,000 or something, which is real cheap, so, you know, get those, put them on. Obviously, the one for your weapon's probably going to cost gems because you need a legendary one of those as well. So you do that, and this is what it should look like. You should have all of your elements, all of your spirits, a legendary weapon, and some, you know, pretty crappy armor, but it'll get you by. And when you do that, for him, it got me to 17,638 power, but he's only level 28, though. If he was, like, level 33 like the rest of my characters, then that would probably be over 20,000. Once you do that, you need to add your seeds in. Like, right here is his attack. So if you got more that you could add, pump them into him, make him stronger. You're going to want to give him the health and defense, obviously, as well. I like to do it all one at a time per hero. That way, each hero gets maxed out, and it goes through it like that. And that'll get you up there with your power. And you do that for every hero, and you'll be up there. Just to show you, let's see if I can look at my lord here. He was originally a knight. I gave him a Titan soul. Now he is stacking defense and these ram runes and mammoth runes. The mammoth runes create additional threat, so the bosses and the enemies will choose to attack him first. So I have a couple of those on him to increase that chance, and the ram is going to give you more percentage defense. So some combination of that will get you there, but also keep in mind any of the heroes that are red also have a passive that they don't tell you about that actually generates more threats. So just adding a couple mammoths will give you that significantly. All right, so that's pretty cut and dry. I'm just going to stop it there, and if you have any questions, just ask.